Click on Show More to read. Along a world is where there is life, such as the mountains, the oceans, a creek or an aquarium, etc. That means ours is the only world known to science, and we should be celebrating this. But our leaders, or masters for those of us who haven't found God, don't want us to know that we are special, that our image is not random, and that only their science is important. There may be many physical worlds, but we have to be born into them the same way we got here, and not by traversing outer space. That is just pure science fiction. I can tell you right now from direct experience, ego aside, that our world is far more beautiful than we can physically see, but physics is just a dream. It comes and goes with life and death. You don't go anywhere when you die. You simply become aware of your ethereal or astral body and a fourth primary color. I have seen them, colors that didn't lose their individuality and turn gray when mixed together. Everything that we can see comes from what we can't see. I pity those who only believe in what they can see. Rock for rock, leaf for leaf, our afterlife world. The ethereal or astral earth, unlike our current world, the physical or phenomenal earth, is an airless region of living light. Light that is responsive to your thoughts. We really do create our own reality. It's just a lot more obvious when our world is a matter of energy and not the energy of matter. We have much to look forward to. The bodies of all creatures are spume-scent bubbles on God's comic dream ocean. We were conceived from joy, we live for joy, and we will return to joy. All personal issues and all enigmas can be resolved through the development of intuition, the divine medium of communication between God and man. Meditation, prayer, and yoga should not be underestimated. Prayer is obvious. Meditation is to develop intuitive reasoning and realization, and yoga is to burn karma, your habits and responsibilities of past deeds. When you die, your consciousness will ascend into your super consciousness, and you will recall with perfect clarity every thought that you ever had. Based on this information, your next life will be determined. What we don't finish in this life, we can finish in the next. We always pick up where we leave off. Not to discount the Bible, but there is a book that really speaks to me. It's called Autobiography of a Yogi. I will leave a link to this book for free online reading. It was written by Paramhansa Yogananda, who is the chief disciple of my guru, the saint and avatar, Swami Sri Yukteswar, the incarnation of wisdom, who died 21 years before I was born and yet appeared to me twice when I was about 5 or 6 years old. Deathless saints are reality, and LL saints share omnipresence and cosmic consciousness. They're everywhere all the time, and they know everything. They won't listen to what you say because they can hear what you are thinking, and they know what is in your heart. A trait that will replace his conversation for us all when we give up the ghost and pass over. Deception does not come easy in this phenomenal joy that we call heaven. There is some sadism there, but it's not prevalent as it is here. Evilness is kept within its own domain, like worms in the ground. Life is a dream, and we are spiritual asleep, but one day we will wake and behold our bodies that never sleeps. May God bless us all, because we only exist in relation to others. Creator, creation, creature, it's really all the same. God gives from himself. Amen. Om. And peace.